Hi, Hein, DIY Van here, and we're working on a Promaster van. It's a 159, brand new. Customer brought it to us, and we're doing a number of projects. They're going to DIY quite a bit of it themselves as well, but because we have a nice heated shop and it's kind of rainy and wet and cold up here in the Northwest right now, it's obviously much better to be working on a van inside than it is in your driveway. So he has hired us to do a number of tasks, insulation, and I have a tech, his name is Marty, did a fantastic job putting this insulation in. This is SM600L. Marty also helped me put a Maxair fan in the back, and this is our framing for the Maxair fan, so super sturdy there. And then we put an RTX 2000 air conditioner in, using our adapter. This has got a spacer on it so that it doesn't protrude into the living space. Obviously that's where the cable's gonna connect to go to the battery system. Again, this was also installed with our frame system. So again, super sturdy, very not gonna bounce around. And also on top of this van, we're gonna be doing our solar rack or our rack system. We're gonna be putting 3 200-watt panels on it so we space the air conditioner or the vent apart so we can have a panel here and in between them. And then two more panels at the front where the rack system is currently out for anodizing, so we're kind of waiting on that. We're gonna put an awning on it, a Fiamma F45S awning using our awning brackets. And today what we did is put our composite floor in this. These are beautiful and really getting a lot of interest on these floors. This is a one piece composite floor for the 159 Promaster. It fits perfectly. It's held down with the factory D-ring bolts. So we drill holes in our floor with the CNC, and then we use the same holes, the same threaded holes that are in the van to hold this floor down. One little detail is because our floor is a little higher, we had to trim off this little piece of trim. So we took it down a little bit, cut off so that it would sit right on top of our floor. It turned out amazing. This floor has the 3/4-inch mini cell on the bottom of the floor. And it's all been CNC machined to fit all the bumps and ribs and whatnot that are in the metal floor. So this thing is locked in as far as it's interfacing with the van. The other thing that we did is a new product and kind of came out of us doing the insulation on this van. These little panels here cover up holes that are accessed, that basically are open to the rocker panel area, so underneath the van and to the side. We did put some insulation in there, but we kept it away from the outside surface of the metal body, and we wrapped it around the inside and glued that on, and then we put these covers on. There's three different sizes. There's a little house cover, a little kidney-shaped cover, and then another one back here that is a rectangle. And so that area has all now been sealed up. Normally that would allow a lot of cold air and noise to come up from underneath the van. So that's gonna help reduce that a significant amount. But the floor turned out great. Other thing we're doing on this van is because the Promaster has a not as deep a roof or not as thick of a ceiling or roof cavity, we're gonna put furring strips on here to make the depth of the ceiling, a depth of the roof a little bit more, about 3/4 inch more. And then we're actually gonna put another layer of SM400L, which is the 1-inch thick insulation, over the top of the 600L that's already there. So with a Promaster and with a lot of other vans, the roof cavity is actually the thinnest. The wall cavities are fairly thick, and that airspace behind your wall panels actually provides some good R value as well. Doesn't do anything for noise, and that's why we have to use a thin slate. But with a roof, especially on a blue van like this, it's going to absorb quite a bit of heat through the sun on the roof. And then we've got those solar panels up there. Even though they're going to be spaced above the roof, they will get hot. So they're getting some heat gain, and in the cold weather, some heat loss right through the roof. So it's not a bad idea to fur out your roof, especially with the Promaster, because it's already kind of not so deep. and then add another layer of insulation in the roof to make it more thermally efficient. So that's our next step, is to put these furring strips in. I'll do a little follow-up video on those. That's something we probably will offer on our site, is furring strips that are specifically made for the Promaster. So yeah, we're really excited to keep working on this van. We're gonna do under vehicle battery boxes on it. And we're gonna put a heater in it. We're gonna locate the S-bar heater right here. That's where the cabinetry will be for when he finishes up his own build. But we're super happy to be working on this. It's turning out great. Obviously we make a lot of these products so you can DIY your own project for your own van. Or if you have, you know, if you want us, we were more than happy to work on it for you and do a number of tasks which you may or may not want to do. We're not really doing a full build here, but we're doing certain specific things that the customer wants us to do that he doesn't want to embark on, and then he's going to kind of take over and do a lot of his own wiring and cabinetry and whatnot. So thank you for watching. Always willing to help you with whatever you got going on in your van projects. Have a great day.